Well, praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Another wonderful day, another wonderful opportunity today to give God the glory, to give God honor, and to give God praise. And therefore today, I would like to encourage you from the book of 2 Timothy chapter 4 and verses 7 and verses 8. I'd like to encourage you today from the book of 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 7 and verses 8. Being a Veterans Day, I want us to be able to read from one of the veterans on what he said. And here he says, this is Paul, I have fought the good fight, I have finished the race, and I have kept the faith. Finally, there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, the righteous judge, will give to me on that day, and not to me only, but also to all who have loved his appearing. Here Paul was writing to Timothy, and he was reminding Timothy that, Timothy, I have set the course. I have fought the good fight. What good fight did Paul fight? He fought the good fight of faith. And then he says, I have finished the race. In other words, whatever I started, I have finished. And then he goes on to say, not only have I done that, but I've also kept the faith. So he's fought the good fight of faith. He's run his race of faith, and then he has finished, or he has kept his faith. You know, being a Veterans Day, the veterans fight to keep or maintain the freedom of this nation. And therefore, they give their lives that they are going to maintain the freedom that this nation was already established for. And so they'll put their life in the forefront. They will spend their nights and their days and their weeks away from family members to make sure that the freedom that the people are enjoying in this nation, or the freedom that the people are able to experience in this nation, is as a result of them fighting the good fight. It is a good fight of maintaining the freedom. It is running to make sure that I run to make sure that the freedom that was already established from the very beginning is maintained, and to keep that at the forefront, so that we who are in this nation can be free to speak, free to live, free to be able to experience the things that we experience. And so Paul was reminding Timothy that, remember, I have fought the good fight of faith, which means you also have to maintain the fight of faith. I have fought it, you maintain it. How do you maintain it? By following the very same examples that I've followed. Those who have fought for our freedom, we need to fight for our freedom. We should not let them go into waste. We should not let them go into drainage. Why? Because somebody gave themselves for it. Just like Jesus gave up his life for us. Therefore, we have to maintain that by maintaining what Jesus has already done for us. So today, I'd like to encourage you. Stand together with the veterans. Appreciate the veterans. Thank them for what they have done for us. And then do them a good will by maintaining what they fought for, which means stand for what they fought for. Paul fought for faith. Stand for faith. Stand for the liberty that has been given to us. And then he goes on to tell Timothy, I have run and finished the race. In other words, we have to maintain and keep on maintaining that which has already been given to us. Run the race that has been set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. And then keep and finish your faith that has been already given to you. Why did Paul do all this? He says this, finally, there is laid up for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord righteous judge will give to me on that day, and not to me only, but to all who have loved his appearing. So here Paul is saying, whatever I have fought for, whatever I have ran for, and whatever I have kept, I'm being rewarded for. And therefore, the veterans have already fought, they have already ran, and they've already kept that which they stood up for. And if we will stand for the same thing, fight for the same thing, maintain and keep it, guess what? There is a reward that is going to come for us, which is freedom, because freedom is never free. Freedom is a payment that has already been made, and we need to maintain that. And we maintain that by doing what? By standing for the very same things that were fought for, by maintaining the very same things that were fought for, and by laying hold of those things that have already been maintained for, and then we pass them on to the next generation, just like Paul was admonishing Timothy. And therefore, today, I'd like to encourage you. You fight the good fight of faith. You run the race that has been set before you, looking unto Jesus. And then you finish up and keep your faith that has already been given to you, because there is a prize awaiting for you. And therefore, when you see a veteran today, thank them for that. And then believe with them by maintaining what they fought for. And when you do so, we will continue to maintain the liberty that has been given to us. So you stay blessed and have a wonderful day.